I don't know if it's just me, but ever since the launch of OBS version 28, which was a while ago, I've been absolutely terrified of updating any single piece of software. Everyone was losing all their settings, all their configurations, absolutely everything. And ever since then, I have made sure that my Mix It Up is taking automatic backups. Because if I will have to recreate everything within Mix It Up, I think I'd be sitting at my desk for at least 3 days straight. And that's what I'm going to show you today, how to set up automatic backups for your Mix It Up so you'll never have to worry about losing a thing. But before we jump into it, the normal YouTuber spiel, if you could like, comment, subscribe, and all that other fun jazz. I'm now streaming on YouTube, so you can always do the bell thing to find out when I go live. But yeah, you should do that because why not? Anyway, it's a short and sweet one for the day. So first thing we're going to do, as always, is open up our Mix It Up. And then from there, we're going to hit the little gear settings at the top. And then from the sidebar, we're going to go down to advanced. Now, for those long-term Mix It Up users out there was an initial prompt within your new installation wizard when you very first set up Mix It Up. Chances are, if you're probably like me initially, probably just hit skip. So I'm going to run you through all these settings because there's a couple of cool things which you can do to make sure that you actually never lose it. First things first is with the first two buttons, backup your current settings and restore a settings backup. This is a pretty self-explanatory. The first one just takes an instant backup for now. And then the second one, this is where you restore your settings. What I like to do is I like to take an instant backup whenever I'm about to update Mix It Up, just again, in case something goes wrong. And then if something did go wrong, you can just hit restore settings here, and then that will revert your Mix It Up back to its beautiful former glory. And these next two buttons, these are where the automatic backups really shine. So the first one is the automatic backup rate. So this is either none, meaning that it won't take any automatic backups. You can set it up as daily, weekly, or monthly. Now for me, I have mine set up as weekly. I mean, I probably only stream about once a week, maybe twice a week on the very rare occasion. So in that case, that something went wrong, if I lost, let's say, all of my daily check-ins for one stream, wouldn't really worry me too much, but depending on how frequent you stream, that's where I'd probably recommend tweaking that setting. If you do stream once a day, probably daily is the one for you. If you're a bit more casual like me, I'd probably just do weekly, or even if you're feeling a bit rogue, you could even do monthly as well. This next button down here, set location, this is where it's going to put all your backups into. So you can see for me, I just have mine within a folder on my desktop, and specifically a backups folder. But this is where you could be a bit smart with it and really, really elevate your Mix It Up backups, as weird as that sounds, by utilizing the power of the cloud. Now, if you wanted to, you could essentially store all your backups into, let's say, a Google Drive folder or a Dropbox folder. And then that way, if your computer absolutely cooks it and for some reason just decides never to turn on again, you have all your backups stored on the cloud. So whenever you get your new computer or whatever you do, you can easily download that from, let's say, your Google Drive or your Dropbox or something like that, and just initially restore it right on that new device. The other scenario in which I thought that this whole Google Drive scenario could be really useful for is in the case that you stream on multiple devices. So you could always just download your most recent backup from the cloud, essentially restore it within the Mix It Up instance, and then, you know, take an immediate backup when you stop streaming. So then when you go and stream again on your home computer, you've got all their settings consistent across the board. Even though I haven't done it, but thinking about it, I very much should. But yeah, definitely upload it all to your Google Drive account, because even for me, I got this whole MacBook Pro bootcamp scenario set up. I don't know, this thing could go tits up within a day. I don't know. So I'm probably going to do that right after this. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much everything with backups. I mean, it's not too sexy to talk about, but let's be honest, it's there when you need it, and you're going to be so grateful for the day that you actually do need it. If you do have any questions, though, please do not hesitate to leave those in the comments down below. It's been me, Drew, your friendly neighborhood Mix It Up ambassador, and I'll see you next time.